chapter. The chapter name is Capital Gain. Okay. You have studied the theory part, okay, and you have studied the format part. Now I will revise the format, then we can move to a problem. Okay, so your capital gain has divided into two types. One is short-term capital asset and long-term capital asset. In theory class you have studied, or I have told already the format. Now once again I will revise. Okay, so short-term capital asset, this is the format. Okay, so sales consideration less realization expenses, net sale consideration less cost of acquisition less cost of improvement, then totally you will get short-term capital gain. Okay, next, in question they will mention the exemptions. So based on the question you should write here, that is exemptions under section 84B, 84D, 84G, etc. Next one is taxable short term capital gain. So this is the format for short term capital gain. You have to see with the question, you have to see which is a short term capital gain and long term capital gain. Okay, next one is long term capital asset. So sales consideration less realization expenses, you will get net sale consideration. Okay, next, less index cost of acquisition, that is a fair market value, less index cost of improvement, that is a gross long term capital gain. Okay, next, less assumptions under section 54B, 54D, 54G, etc. And this is a taxable long-term capital gain. So this is a format for long-term capital gain as well as short-term capital gain. This format is very, very important. While doing a problem, we will use this format. Okay. Let's move on. First problem. Mr. Prasanna sold his residential house on 1/1/20 for rupees 35,06,000, which he had purchased in 2001-2 for rupees 2 lakh. He spent rupees 6,000 for sale of house. He also spent rupees 1,50,000 on the construction of new house and deposited rupees 1 lakh. Under capital gain account scheme on 28/3/2020, the CII means cost influence index for 2001-2 and 2019-20 are 100 and 289 respectively. Compute taxable capital gain for the assessment year 2020-21. So let's solve a problem. So problem number one. See, your question tells that Mr. Prasanna sold his residential house on 1/1/20 for rupees 35,06,000. So what is that? Sold his residential house. Okay. Sold his residential house is rupees 35,06,000 is rupees 35,06,000, which he had purchased in 2001-2 for rupees 2 lakh. So it's a cost of acquisition. So here cost of acquisition is rupees 2 lakh. Next, he spent rupees 6,000 for sale of house. So sale of house is 6,000. Sale of house is rupees 6,000. He also spent 1,50,000 on construction of new house. Okay, so he spent construction of new house, it's 1,50,000. So construction of new house is rupees. New house and deposited, right? Deposited is rupees 1,50,000. Under capital gain account scheme on 28-3-2020. So your capital gains accounts schemes is rupees 1,00,000. Influence index is 2001 to 2 and 2019 to 20. It's 100 and 289. That is 2001 to 2002 and 2019 to 2020 is 289. Compute taxable capital gain for the assessment year 2020 to 2021. So here it's a long term capital gain. So the format is long term capital gain. Okay. So based on this format, let's solve a problem. Okay. So previous year and the assessment year, that is 2019 to 2020 and 2020 to 2021, and your accessee is a Mr. Prasanna. And status is resident. Particular and the amount column. So in long term capital gain, the format first one is sale consideration. So sales consideration. So here sold his resident house, that is 35,06,000. So sold consideration, here you write 35,06,000. Next, realization expenses less realization expenses. So here sale of house, how much it is? 6,000. Write here 6,000. This is a net sales consideration. You should minus, okay, 35,06,000 minus 6,000, you will get 35,00,000. 35,00,000. Next step is we should see the index cost of acquisition. Okay, next step is index cost of acquisition. So your index cost of acquisition, the format is cost of acquisition or fair market value divided by cost influence index of purchase year into cost influence index of previous year. So the question already they mentioned the cost of acquisitions rupees 2 lakh. So interest cost of acquisition rupees 2 lakh divided by 100, that is 2001 to 20, it's a 100 into 2019 to 20 is 289. Just you calculate how much you will get. That is 2 lakh divided by 100 into 289. You will get 5,78,000. So right here, 5,78,000. After that, you total it, that you will get gross long term capital gain. So you should minus it from 35 lakh minus 5,78,000. So you'll get 28,22,000. Okay, so 29,22,000 you will get, and next you should minus, that is exemption list, that is exemption section is 54. Exemption section is 54. There in the question they has given the construction of new house and deposits. It's 1,50,000 right here. So point number one, that is construction of new house and deposit is 1,50,000. And capital gain account schemes is rupees 1 lakh. So right here, capital gains accounts scheme, that is 1 lakh. So you minus it, you will get the net long term capital gain. So minus from 2,29,22,000 minus 1,50,000 minus 1 lakh, you will get 26,72,000. So here the final answer you will get, net long term capital gain, final answer you will get 26,72,000. So in the format is that sales consideration we got here, that he sold his residual house, that is 35,06,000, and we wrote here next we have to minus, that is realization expenses. In questions gives like realization expenses like sale of house 6,000 or brokerage or commission, then based on that you should write realization expenses, and you minus it, you will get sales consideration, that is net sale consideration. After that, interest cost of acquisition, you should write a formula, and based on formula you should calculate, and final answer you will get 5,78,000, and you minus it, so you will get gross long term capital gain, that is 29,22,000. Next, let's exemptions and list section 54. So in question they has given construction of new house and deposit is 1,50,000, and capital gain account scheme is 1 lakh. and you minus it everything, and the answer will get 26,72,000. That is a net long term capital gain. Okay. Problem 2. Ram was the owner of 2 house properties at Bangalore, of which one resident house was sold on 28-2-2020 for 20 lakhs. His house was purchased by him on 1-1-1979 for rupees 1,50,000. He had made some additional to his house by spending rupees 3,000 on 23-19-80. Further added a room to his house at the cost of rupees 1 lakh on 14-11-2015. The fair market value of his house on 1-4-2001 was 15,000. He purchased new residential house at Mysore on 25-3-2020 for 2 lakh. Compute capital gain for the assessment year 2021 CII for 19-20-89, 14-15-40, 2001-2002, it's 100. So this is a question. Let's solve a problem. So problem number 2. Okay. And see, a question has said Ram was the owner of 2 house properties at Bangalore, for which one residential house was sold on 28-2-2020 for, that is, 20 lakh. Okay. So here a residential house, that is 20 lakh. Okay. Next. His house was purchased by him on 1-1-1979 for rupees 1,50,000. That is cost of acquisition. Cost of acquisition is 1,50,000. Yes, he had made some additional to his house by spending 3,000. So he had make some additional expenses. So additional expenses, that is 3,000. Further headed by a room to his house at the cost of rupees 1 lakh. So here house, that is rupees 1 lakh. And the fair market value of his house, that is 1-4-2001, was 15,000. Here fair market value rupees is 15,000. Okay. He had purchased new residential house at Mysore, that is 2 lakh. So he had paid 2,000. That is residential house. New residential house. And next one is compute capital gain, the assessment year 2021, that is CII. Okay, CII, that is 19-20, it's 289, and 14-15 is 240. Next, 2001-2002, it's 100. Okay, so this is a question. Let's move to a problem. So problem number 2. So you should mention the previous year and the assessment year, that is 2019-20, 2020-21. Okay, next one is the amount column. Thank you. program. Next one is status is resident. Okay. Yeah. So sale consideration is rupees 20 lakh. So sales consideration is rupees 20 lakh. And less realization expenses. So in question they did not mention realization expenses, so you should give nil. So right here 20 lakh, this is a net sale consideration. After that, Indus cost of acquisition, that is Indus cost of acquisition 1,50,000, and in question they have mentioned fair market value 15,000. In this, whichever is less, that amount we should take. Okay, so here less index cost of acquisition. So index cost of acquisition or fair market value divided by cost influence index of purchase year into previous year. Okay, so you should take whichever is low. So 15,000, we should take here 15,000 into, we should take 100 value because the question has given, that is 2001 to 2002. So you should take this value, that is 100 divided by 289. Okay, just calculate how much you will get. 15,000 divided by 100 into 289. So you will get 43,350. Next, in question they have mentioned, that is Indus cost of improvement. Okay, so the value is 1 lakh. So Indus cost of improvement divided by cost influence index of improvement into cost index influence previous year. So your 1 lakh divided by 240, because the question has given, that is 14 to 15, that is 240 into 289. Okay, calculate how much 1 lakh divided by 240 into 289. You will get 120,417. Okay, then after that you minus it, that is a gross long term capital gain. Minus it, how much you will get? So 43,350 minus 12 4 7 minus 20, you will get 18,36,233. Okay, after that less exemption under section 84, and this is a new resident house. New resident house, how much? Question is 2000. Okay, write your 2000 and minus it. Minus 18,36. Okay. You will get 16,36,233. This is a net long term capital gain. Okay, so you should mind. So you see, sales consideration 20 lakh, and less realization expenses. In question they did not mention. Okay, it's a nil, and 20 lakh. Okay, now see, this cost of acquisition, after calculating you will get 43,350. After that you have, in question they have mentioned in this cost of improvement. So while calculating you will get 1,20,470. Okay, and you minus these three, you will get 18,36,233. Okay, then you have exemption. Okay, exemption under section 54, and you that is new resident housing question they have mentioned 2 lakh. So mention your 2 lakh and minus it, you will get 16,36,233. Third problem, agricultural land purchased by Mr. X in 2004-05 for rupees 90,000, sold for rupees 15 lakh on 1/6/2019. The accessee purchased another piece of agricultural land on 1/9/2019 for rupees 98,000 and deposit rupees 60,000 on 1/7/2019 in capital gain account schemes 1988. Find out the capital gains chargeable into tax for assessment year 20-21. The CII in 2004-05, 113, 2019-20, 289. So let's solve a problem. So problem number 3. So in question they has given Mr. Yes in 2004 to 2005 rupees 90,000. So here index cost of inflation, so index cost of acquisition, that is 90,000. Okay, then sold for rupees 15 lakh. So here sold for rupees how much? 15 lakh. On 1/6/2019, the accessee purchased another piece of agricultural land on 1/9/2019, rupees 98,000. So what is it? Agricultural land. Okay, that is 98,000. Okay, I deposited rupees 60,000. On 1/7/2019 in capital gain or in capital gains account scheme 1988. Okay, find out the capital gain chargeable to for assessment year, that is 20-21. The CII. CII in 2004 to 5 is 113 and 2019 to 20 it's 289. Okay, so this is a question. So based on this, let's solve a problem. So here, previous year and the assessment here, that is 2019 to 2020, 2020 to 2021. Okay, so your particular amount column. So sales consideration format is sales consideration. Sale consideration sold the value is 15 lakh. So right here 15 lakh. Next one is realization expenses. In question they did not give realization expenses. In question they did not mention. So just totally, so you will get 15 lakh. So here net sale consideration. Okay. Next, in question they have mentioned in this cost of acquisition, that is rupees 90,000. Okay. So let's index cost of acquisition. So index cost of acquisition, it's a long term capital gain. Okay, so index cost of acquisition is equal to cost of acquisition divided by index. So cost influence index of the year of acquisition into index cost of previous year. So year 90,000. Okay, 90,000 divided by 113. Into 289. So 289. Calculate how much you will get. 90,000 divided by 113 into 289. You will get 230176. Next, after that, in question they has given less exemptions. Okay, less exemption. Under section 54B. That is purchase during the year, that is 98,000. Okay, so purchase during previous year, that is 98,000. Next, amount deposit in capital gain account scheme 1988, that is 60,000. Okay. I minus it. So 15 lakh minus 0176 minus 98,000 minus 60,000. You will get 11,11,823. So this is a taxable long term capital gain. So final you will get answer 11,11,823. Okay. Problem 4. Mr. Manik purchased a plot in 2004-05 for rupees 2 lakh. It was sold on 15-1-2020 for rupees 20 lakh and he paid rupees 3 lakh as brokerage charges. He invested rupees 1 lakh in NHAI bonds and rupees 2,10,000 in bond issued by Rural Development Corporation Limited. Computed his taxable capital gain CII for 2004-05, that is 113, 2019-20, 289. So let's do a problem. Problem number 4. Yes. Question tells that Mr. Manik purchased a plot in 2004-05 for rupees 2 lakh. So this is the index cost of acquisition. So index cost of acquisition, how much it is? 2 lakh. He was sold on 15-1-2020 for rupees 20 lakhs. So sold how much? It's 20 lakh. And he paid 3 lakh as brokerage charges. So brokerage charges how much? 3 lakh. Brokerage charges is 3 lakh. He invested rupees 1 lakh in NHAI bonds, that is 1 lakh. So NHAI bonds, that is how much? 1 lakh. And rupees 2,10,000 in bond issued by Rural Development Corporate Limited is, that is 2,10,000. So what is a Rural Development Corporation Limit, that is 2,10,000. Next, compute his taxable capital income, that is CII, that is for 2004-2005 is 113, 2019-2020 is 289. Okay. So this is a problem. Let's, this is a question. Okay, let's do a problem. it's a long term capital gain. So based on long term capital gain, you should use the format. So previous year assessment year. So 2019 to 2020, 2020 to 2021. So particular and amount column. So first the format is sales consideration. Sales consideration, how much they has given? 20 lakh. Right here, 20 lakh. Less realization expenses. So realization expenses, that is brokerage, that is 3 lakh. So brokerage you write, okay? Charges, it's 3 lakh. Add it, sorry, minus it, okay? You should minus that, you will get net sales consideration. Okay, you minus how much you will get, let's see. So 20 lakh minus 3 lakh, you will get 17 lakh. Okay. Yes. And in question, they have mentioned the Indus cost of acquisition. So Indus cost of acquisition amount is 2 lakh. Okay. So less index cost of acquisition. So the formula is index cost of acquisition is divided by CAI of purchase year into index influence of previous year. So it's 2 lakh. Okay, we write here 2 lakh divided by, the year is 2004 to 5, the year, so the value is 113, right here 113 into 289. So calculate how much you will get. So 2 lakh divided by 113 into 289, you will get 51,150. Okay. After that, next the question has given exempted list. Okay. So less exemption. Okay. That is under section 54. So here, that is NHAI. So it's a 1 lakh. So NHAI, it's a 1 lakh Next, Rural Development Corporate Limited, that is 2 lakh 10,000. So right here, Rural Development Corporate Corporation Limited, you will get 2,10,000. You should minus it, you will get net long term capital gain. So let's do minus 117 lakh. Minus 51,150 minus 1 lakh minus 2,10,000. You will get 13,38,850. So this is a net, that is a long term capital gain. So how we will get? So sales consider based on format we should do, that is sales consideration in question they have mentioned 20 lakh because sold, okay, sold is 20 lakh. After that the realization expenses the question has given, that is a brokerage charges, that's a 3 lakh minus it, you will get 17 lakh. Next in question they has given cost, in this cost of acquisition you should do a formula and you should calculate. So after final answer you will get 51,150, and you have exemption list, that is under section 54, that is NHAI, that is 1 lakh. We wrote here 1 lakh. Next, Rural Development Corporate Limited, that is 2,10,000, and you minus all those things, you will get final answer, that is 13,38,850. It's a net long term capital gain. Okay. Problem 5. Mr. Harish purchased a plot in 2001-2 for ₹2 lakh. It was sold on 15-1-2020 for ₹26,80,000, and he paid ₹2 lakh as brokerage charges. He invested ₹2 lakh in NHAI bonds and ₹3,10,000 in bonds issued by Rural Electronification Corporation Limited. Compute its taxable gain for the assessment year 2022-21. If CII 2001-2 it's 100, 2004-5 113, 2019-20 208. So let's solve a problem. So problem number 5. So your question tells that Mr. Harish purchased a plot in 2001-2 for ₹2 lakh. This is a cost of acquisition. So cost of acquisition is ₹2 lakh. It was sold on 15-1-2020 for rupees, that is 26,80,000. So sold, okay. Sold ₹26,80,000. He paid 2 lakh, that is has brokerage expense, brokerage charges. Okay, so your brokerage brokerage charges is ₹2 lakh. He invested ₹2 lakh in NHAI bonds and ₹3,10,000 in bonds issued by Rural Electrification Corporation Limited. So here So N H A I bonds. That is 2 lakh. I bonds issued by Rural Electrification Corporation Limited is rupees 3,10,000. 3,10,000. Next, compute its taxable gain for assessment year. Okay, so for assessment year, that is 2020 to 2021, that is CII 2001 to 2002 is 100. 2004 to 2005 is 113, and 2019 to 2020 is 289. So this is a question. Okay, based on this question, let's do a problem. So year, previous year, and the assessment year, that is 2019 to 2020, 2020 to 2021. Year accessing Mr. Harish, and status is resident. And this format is long term capital gain. Okay, this format based on long term capital gain will solve a problem. Okay, so particular and amount column. So your sale consideration format is sales consideration is 26,80,000. So 26,80,000 less realization expenses, that is brokerage charges. How much? 2 lakh. Right here, 2 lakh. Minus it, you will get net sales consideration. So 26,80,000 minus 2 lakh, you will get 24,80,000. So 24,80,000. Next one is index cost of acquisition. So index cost of acquisition, format is index cost of acquisition or fair market value divided by index cost, index influence of purchase year into index influence cost, index influence of previous year. So your cost of acquisition is 2 lakh. Write down 2 lakh divided by 2001 1 to 2 it's 100, right here 100 into 2019 to 20 is 289. So 289, just calculate how much you will get. So 2 lakh divided by 100 into 289, you will get 5,78,000. Next one is, in this cost of improvement, in this question they did not give any improvement, so no need to write. Okay, after that you add it. Okay, that you, sorry, you should minus, that is gross long term capital gain. Okay, you minus it from 24,80,000 minus 5,78,000. So you will get 19,02,000. Okay, 19,02,000. Next, you have exemption. Okay, less exemption under section 54. Okay, so your exemption is NHAI. Okay, NHAI bond is 2 lakh. So NHAI bond is 2 lakh. Next point is, bonds issued by Rural Electrification Corporations Limited is 3,10,000. So bonds issued by Rural Electrification Corporation Limited is 3,10,000. Okay, I'll rub this part. So 3,10,000, and just minus it. Okay, minus from 19,02,000 minus 2 lakh minus 3,10,000. You will get 13,92,000. So this is a net long term capital gain. Okay, so this format is based on long term capital gain. Okay, and we use the long term capital gain format. In question they has given sales consideration, that is 26,80,000, and realization expenses the question has given, that is what is the brokerage charges, that is 2 lakh, and you minus it, you will get 24,80,000, that is a net sale consideration. Okay, and they has given in question that is Indus cost of acquisition. There is a formula you should calculate, and final answer you will get 5,78,000. Minus it, you will get 19,02,000. That is a gross long-term capital gain. Next, less exemptions under section 54EC. There is an exemption that is NHAI bonds, that is 2 lakh bonds issued by Rural Electrification Corporate Limited, that is 3,10,000, and you minus it, that is long term, net long term capital gain is that 13,92,000. Okay.